Hey guys, this is Kartikeya Kantwal again from Apex Finserv, and it's the weekend. So after a long break, we're back with the weekend series of videos, and this time we'll be discussing something that's requested quite a bit often from you guys, that is the concept of TSL or trailing stop losses. Before you go into using TSL, you should know what is it, when to use it, when not to use it. Now, TSL or trailing stop loss, most of you might be aware of it, that it's used to lock in your profits and whatnot in your trades. But the thing is, a lot of people I have observed are not really using the method of trailing stop losses, or even, you know, it's difficult to understand if you should use trailing stop loss or not if you don't understand the method of your own trading. Whether to use a trailing stop loss or not is the first question that you should be able to answer, and then moving on to how or what method to use while applying that TSL. Before going to the method of applying TSL or trailing stop losses, you should must of course be aware that TSL is only beneficial to those of you who are using trend following trading methods, because as always, I guess it is elementary, it is a basic piece of information that the market is always self-correcting in nature, and any trend in the market, if it is established, it is going to be going on unless and until there's a change of character or change of structure based on the larger time frame price action charts. Now, if you are using some method that gives you trend following entries, such as a crossover method with confirmation of phase analysis or structure break, which is one of the simplest method to do things, by the way, or if you are simply using a method of trailing, or not trailing but rather trading, which I shared with you, if you remember the EMA crossover 9 and 26 if I'm not wrong, with the VWAP and ADR, which I shared with you guys last month. I believe it was somewhere between October and not October for sure, it was in September, August or September. But if you're using a method like that, that relies heavily on the underlying trend to maximize your gains, then for people like those, you know, TSL is going to be beneficial. But if you're somebody like me that takes counter trend positions based on strong demand zones, supply zones, we cannot really afford to use trailing stop losses, because we have very, very aggressive entries, or at least talking about myself, I have really aggressive entries, and it doesn't really make a lot of logical sense for me to, instead of lock in my gains at my primary target, but then rather to trail my stop loss at cost and then wait for the trend to change entirely, because that is something that's going to happen once in a blue moon and not every day. Whereas as trend, you know, counter trend traders, I aim more towards the consistency and accuracy side of things. So for me, achieving the primary target is a far more important thing rather than maximizing my gains on each and every trade using TSL. Now the thing with TSL in counter trend trades is, if I bring my stop loss to cost or slightly above cost, every pullback after my first target has the potential possibility to erode my running gains and then give me a TSL hit, and again it might go in my direction or it might not. Now I cannot say this while entering in a position, because this is a piece of information that I will not have until I'm actually out of that position. So there's no possible way for me to know that while entering the entry order. So for me, or as per my method of trading, I believe not using TSL is rather the best method. But let's say you have a highly trend following approach, you are one of the sensible guys who believes that the trend is your friend and you should always align with the general direction of the market, and you're not, well, stupid like me. Now in that case, you should use the TSL. But even then, if you're using a trend following method, you should also know that trend following methods are most effective on larger time frames where you have adequate holding period to make the most out of the underlying trend. If you're a positional or a swing trader, that works out well for you. I am more than happy for you, you know, more power to you. But if you are a strictly intraday trader limited by, you know, let's say margins, for example, or the time you can give to the markets, in that case, trend following may TSL use karna bhi, it's not going to help you as much. Because a TSL considers, you know, if you use structure analysis for placing your TSL, it's going to consider everything. It's going to consider gaps. It's going to consider, you know, larger swing based movements. So it's not really going to work that way. If you're an intraday trader and you're using TSL, even in a trend-friendly approach, a trend-friendly approach is going to give you more or less the exact same targets, or maybe 10 or 15% more of a target size with respect to its relative counter-trend, you know, sibling method. In which case, again, trend even on a trend-following system which is strictly restricted to intraday trades, using of a TSL is not something that I'd recommend. But let's say you want to try it for the heck of it. Now in that case, if you are hellbent on using a TSL method, then we have two ways, or at least I prefer using two ways to place a TSL. First one is assuming that you are lazy and you want to rely on indicators that ease out your job while applying your TSL. Now in that case, there are lots of indicators that you can use. I have a couple of charts prepared for you guys. Let me see if I can switch. That is not it. Alright, so what we have here is we have a, first of all, you know, defining the entry condition for you guys. It's a simple structure based entry. You can see it was a clear low high formation. And if you have seen my video on how to use VWAP effectively, then you know that on a you know, lower high formation, a phase and structure that is signifying downtrend, every pullback or to the VWAP is an opportunity to sell, or and vice versa in an uptrend. Now I have taken the liberty to consider the short entry here. I assume that you have watched my videos on VWAP. If you haven't, please check them out. They should clear this out for you. It is a pretty basic concept. You should be able to understand it in no time. Now there are a lot of methods to use a TSL method. First of all, talking about the entry here itself. So you would have been a short entry here, going by the lower high formation. Now at the point of entry, your stop loss would have been, let's say, 1%. Till this point, you know, you enter the short possibly at 20 to 80, with your stop loss being at 20 to 95 20 to 90. After that case, you saw it started moving in your favor, so you wanted to maximize on it. Ideally, I recommend people to use a target of close to 0.8 to 1% on intraday trades. 0.1% in this case would have been roughly 20 points from 20 to 80, which means about 20 to 60, if I'm not wrong, which would have been at this point here. Now let me just change this color real quick, because if it's red, it's not going to make a lot of sense to you. So that would have been your 1% target being met, and you would have been out of that trade no matter what. Now let's say that is not how you want to proceed. What you want to do is be the smart guy out there, align yourself with the trend, and use a trailing stop loss. Now to use a trailing stop loss based on an indicator, you have lots of methods. You can use the PSAR, you can use the RSI values, you can also use the ADR values. I find the ADR values to be a not the best way, but at least the better way of setting a TSL value based off of an indicator, because the ADR is nothing but your average trading range. It reflects the volatility per candle basis. Now what we do here is a simple short entry at VWAP pullback. After it has moved a certain percent, let's say after it moved, you know, 0.5% in your favor, let's say it broke this 0.5% range in your favor, in that case you'd like to place a TSL. Now your TSL would be the previous candles, and it was a short position, this one, so your TSL would be previous candles high plus your entry candles ADR values. So your entry candles ADR value was about 10 points. Previous candles high was 20 to 70. Plus you add 10 points, that brings your TSL to roughly at cost, which would have been about 20 to 80 points, or at this point here. Now at this point, you do have reduced exposure, because even if it reverses completely, your loss is minimal. And if you're lucky, your brokerage is covered as well. But it did not reverse and it went down. Now in this case, you would have been trailing every candle. You would have had to stick to the charts. And at this candle, with this candle's closing price being 20 to 40, your trailing stop loss would have been again 10 points here. So that is where your TSL might have been hit, at 20 to 50. So you would have caught about 30 points here, which in this case accounts to 1.5%, which is, well, a whopping 50% more than my suggested intraday 1% targets. But it's not very regular that you have a strong trending day. This was Jubilant Foods and it has been in a downtrend. Now there are other ways to use a TSL method too. This happens to be one of the simplest methods. Just the only requirement is, or the only prerequisite is, that you need to be able to you need to be able to sit in front of your chart. You need to be able to change your ADR values. You need to be able to change your TSL values as per every candle's close, which actually makes you manage your trade in a very, very active manner. I am more of a bracket order person. I enter my order and then I forget it. Now that again is because of my trading style, because I don't use TSL. If you use TSL, you cannot do the a fire and forget order type. You need to be there to manage your position. Now let's say this is not the method that you want to go with. What you would like to go with is something that makes use of your skill, you know, how good you are at analysis, that is something I cannot say, but something that makes use of your depth of analysis. The more you know, the better you get, or the better it is for you and your trading account. In that case, we move on to the phase analysis method of your trailing stop losses. Now in this case, I've simply highlighted a strong trend on this chart. This is Axis Bank with this 1 hour time frame. You had a clear lower, low, lower high formation, followed by a clear change in phase into transition of higher highs and higher lows. If you have watched my phase analysis video, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. If you haven't, please go check it out. Now, yahan pe we had a clear phase change from, we had a clear lower, low, lower high swing leg, range bound, break of range, again, lower, low, lower high continuation. Once that was broken decisively, after that, we could have taken a long position after this break or swing high at every pullback. However, keep in mind that this is not something that I'm talking about from an intraday perspective. So don't just shout on me in the comment section below ki ye to hourly time frame hai. As I said before, trend following may one, you know, anything that allows you to carry over, that is going to allow you to make the most out of the underlying trend in the markets. So if you're a positional and swing guy, this is going to work really great for you. If not, then well, you can stop watching right now because the ATR was all I had for you guys. However, let's say you want to try this on a smaller time frame because you think my advices are not really useful, then you can go practice this on a 5 minutes time frame as well. It's going to work, I mean, mostly, but try it out for yourself and let me know in the comment section below. Now, coming back to this particular trade, you could have taken an entry, a very clear entry rather, at this break of previous swing high, which would have been at this point. So every pullback would could have been a long entry, or if you were a one lot guy, then you had one entry here and that's it. As per phase analysis, your first stop loss would have gone here. I'll change the color again so that it's visible for you. As per phase analysis, that's where your first stop loss would have been, under the previous swing low. After that, because this is a swing and positional trade method, you do not have any preliminary targets. You do not have any base level of target that you are looking for. You are looking to make the maximum of the underlying trade. In that case, the logical way is to trail your stop loss so that you are locking in your profit as the trend is increasing its momentum, so that even if the momentum fades out all of a sudden because of news or any black swan event or whatsoever, in even the worst case scenario, you come out with some profits, which is better than no profits. Now, after that, every pullback, you can either enter new positions or you can move your stop loss to the previous pullback. After the price makes a new high, let's say you took an entry here, break of swing high. After the price makes a new high, which would have been this point, and this point, you could have shifted your stop loss to each of these red lines that I've made. This one, and this one. So typically, on a trade like this, you would have gone long on the 5th of October, close to 450 rupees. Your stop loss would have been at roughly 415 rupees, which is what, 35 rupees worth of stop loss. And the trade would have still been running at 507 rupees because the TSL is not hit at all. Once every previous swing high breaks, you trail your stop loss to the previous swing low. So at this point, we have achieved almost 1:2. Yeah, 1:2 has been done and we are almost at 1:3 as well. Now, yahan pe the trade would have still been running with your TSL being at 487, 490 now. So that means you would have already locked in close to 50 rupees on Axis Bank, which is, I believe, a bit more than 10% now. So, you know, phase analysis works, guys. It really does work. Especially if you are somebody that that enjoys reading candlesticks or enjoys price action analysis, then phase analysis is pretty much as good as it gets. Let's look at another example, you know, because why not? It's the weekend video. So this is Jubilant Foodworks. We discussed Jubilant Foodworks before. Yeah, right. This was Jubilant Foodworks on the 15 minutes. Now, performing the same thing on Jubilant Foodworks that we did on Axis Bank, 1 hour time frame, phase analysis, and that's all. We had a clear higher high, higher low formation. If you can see, it was in a strong uptrend. But then the structure broke, the swing low was taken away, and it had a big uprise again, but could not be sustained. And then we had clear transition into lower lows and lower highs. Once we had a complete lower high swing leg, we had a healthy entry point. I have marked it here, but wait, we had a healthy entry point here at the break of previous swing low, with the first stop loss going in at about here. So your entry would have been at 2340 with your first stop loss going at 2420 2430. Now every time it broke the swing low, all you had to do was trail your stop loss to slightly above the previous swing high. That is literally all that you had to do. Now the only thing here is you need to give it some room for movement, because it is possible that it retraces and slightly touches the swing high level, but doesn't really close above it. So if you're comfortable giving it a bit extra room for movement, do that. If not, then you can consider adding the ATR values above the, or under the swing high, swing low, depending on the direction of your trade, and mix both the phase analysis and the indicator side of things to get a better approach of doing things, or a better method of doing things. Now this was a simple explanation on how to trail your stop loss. In personally, I am not advocating for usage of TSLs. I don't find them useful at all for intraday trades. But if you are somebody that has a swing or positional outlook or approach towards trading, then usage of TSL can actually allow you to make the most out of your trades, because you never know when some trend may completely reverse and invalidate a structure because of news or whatsoever. In such cases, it can really save your profits. What else do you want from the markets? This marks the end of this video, guys. For the coming week, I was thinking to do something on chart patterns. So let me know in the comment section below whether you want chart patterns or something else, or a completely newly developed trading system for you guys. Also, all of the videos that I've shared before, the weekend videos, have you actually been using them? Or if so, which one did you like the most? Let me know in the comment section below. I'll be back tomorrow, guys, with the analysis for Monday's trading session. Thank you so much for watching. Also, I would like to know, what was your last week's performance? I like to discuss these things with my my group of traders. So I do that. If you want to share your performance with me, let me know in the comment section below. This is it for tonight, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful weekend with your friends and family. Good night. Bye.